There are people who go out and party sober. There are people who live these lives.
Avoiding alcohol in January is a common trend. It can be a refresh button after all that holiday partying. But there's a growing trend of those who practice sobriety all year round. January is just another month.
We don't have bars to go to. We don't have these communities to be a part of, so we need to create them for ourselves.
Marie is part of the Boring Little Girls Club for sober women, non-binary, and trans people. This January, they're hosting a fundraiser called Try Dry, raising money for the dope team.
We are challenging our normie friends, normies are people who drink normally, to go without mind-altering substances for the month of January.
Sober Saturdays is similar, hosting alcohol-free events in Edmonton and BC. Sober dating apps are also on the rise. You ain't never listen to me. But when it comes to New Year's, that usually means getting ready, getting drinks, and going out. But it can be an uncomfortable night for those who don't drink.
You know, for the general public, that it's like, wow, we have sober January, and I think that's extremely commendable. But for an awful lot of people, this is more than just a month of the year. It's an entire lifestyle.
The Fresh Start Recovery Center is hosting a sober dance on New Year's Eve, a night free of temptation for those in recovery, or just a fun night out without the option of alcohol for others.
You know, one of the key things is that people really get to understand that they're not alone.
The Boring Little Girls Club hopes to create spaces like that all year round, in a world where drinking is the norm.
We live in a society that glamorizes the consumption of alcohol and drugs.
Whether it's New Year's, January, or 365 days a year, it's apparent that for those seeking sober communities, the world is ready to accommodate.
The reason that things are catching on like wildfires is because there's a need for it.
In Calgary, Taylor Braat, City News.